Did you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I wish I could be.
Common pattern that's seen in a lot of myths and mythical stories is what the anthropologist Joseph Campbell called the hero's journey. This is a pattern that we see in stories from all over the world, from all sorts of different times. In this video, we'll take a look at the basic pattern of the hero's journey.
Did you ever know that you're my hero?
The hero's journey usually starts with somebody called out of everyday life into the world of the unknown, often the world of the supernatural. In the course of this adventure, the hero overcomes his or her own limitations and returns transformed. The hero's journey is often pictured as a circle, where the protagonist ends up back where he started at the beginning, but he's no longer the same person he was at the beginning. His journey has transformed him and has equipped him to deal with challenges in his world in a way that he wasn't able to do at the very beginning of the story. We can see the hero's journey both in traditional myths and in literary works. I'd like to take a look at a specific example from a work that's both myth and literary work, Vergil's Aeneid. The Aeneid is an epic poem. That is, a heroic story told in poetic form. It was composed in Latin by the Roman poet Vergil and first published over 2,000 years ago, in the year 17 BC. It tells of how the Trojan hero Aeneas escaped from the destruction of the city Troy and came to Italy to be the founder of the Roman nation. In his Aeneid, Vergil draws heavily on elements from Homer's Greek epics, the Iliad and the Odyssey. In fact, the Aeneid is intended to be a sort of sequel to those stories, which were first written down 7 or 8 centuries before Vergil's time, and had been recounted orally for probably generations before that. In his new story, Vergil includes a lot of material from traditional Greek and Roman stories, but also many things of his own invention. Aeneas' story starts out with the fall of the city Troy at the end of the Trojan War, although the poem itself doesn't start here. Like Homer's poems, it starts in the middle of the story, in medias res, as the Romans used to say. Also, while Aeneas is not, strictly speaking, an ordinary person, because he's a prince and he's the son of the goddess Venus, but he's also a homeless refugee from a conquered city with only a few hundred followers. He's in no position, yet, to establish a new nation. Aeneas encounters various threshold guardians along the way, such as the Harpies, the Cyclops Polyphemus, and the monsters Scylla and Charybdis. His biggest challenge, however, is the goddess Juno, who tries to keep him from his destiny of founding the new Troy, which is Rome, in Italy. She throws many obstacles in his way, including sending a huge storm at sea to wreck his fleet. Aeneas does have a number of helpers along the way, but his primary mentor is his mother Venus, who intervenes at various points to help him along. By the way, the word mentor itself comes from Homer's Odyssey, where the goddess Athena assists Odysseus' son Telemachus, disguised as an old man named Mentor. In the Aeneid, Venus likewise often appears to Aeneas in human disguise. His greatest temptation is Dido, the queen of Carthage in North Africa, for whom he almost abandons his mission. His parting from her at the prompting of the god Mercury saves his mission, but will have serious consequences centuries later for Rome and for Carthage, and more immediately for Dido herself.
Thank you.
The death and rebirth experience that is the climax of the hero's journey is often only metaphorical or symbolic. It can be something simple as traveling over a body of water. In Vergil's Aeneid, it's a little more literal. Aeneas makes an actual descent into the underworld, the land of the dead. At this point, Aeneas is ready to come to Italy and fulfill his destiny. He atones for his temporary abandonment of his mission with Dido in Carthage by defeating the Italian leader Turnus in single combat. Only after he defeats Turnus is Aeneas able to marry the local Italian princess Lavinia. In doing so, he unites the refugees from Troy with the local people called the Latins, and so creates the Roman nation, the new Troy. The Aeneid is just one example of a general pattern that we can see repeated countless times around the world and through the ages, from the ancient Babylonian epic of Gilgamesh to modern-day stories as diverse as Star Wars or the Hobbit stories by J.R.R. Tolkien. The hero's journey seems to touch on a universal experience, something that speaks to the experience of all humanity.